Hey, welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today on the sawmill, I got a little cedar. It's 12 inch on the little end, 8.5 foot long. We're gonna be cutting some one bys out of it. We'll get started and get it cut up. I didn't say it before we got started, but bought these cedars. They were supposed to be cut off above the fence. I don't know if you can see these. That's why I took off such a deep slab to start with. I dug into here and figured out how deep the staples were and cut down underneath them. Didn't sound like it hit any of them. Don't see any shiny spots, so it looks like we got underneath them.
May have been a little hard to hear. I'm gonna go over that again, that this log had four strand barbed wire fence in it. I turned it up and dug down with a chisel until I found where the actual staple was, because it was growed into the tree, covered completely over for an inch or so. I dug down to the top of the staple and then guessed at how long a staple it was. Dropped the blade just a little below that to make my first cut. So in this video, I'm actually cutting four cedar logs. I'm cutting up fascia boards for the sawmill shed, trying to get it wrapped up before spring gets here. What I'm needing to end up with is about 100 feet of 1x9 and 100 feet of 1x6 for my fascia boards for this building. These logs that I've got to deal with that I bought, they're about 11 to 12 inches on the small end. And of course I'm trying to get primarily all heartwood for this fascia board. So that doesn't leave you 9 to 10 inches of round heartwood, so by the time you do much squaring on it, it's really tight to try to get these 9-inch boards out of these 12-inch cedars, but that's what I'm making an attempt to do. So we got the first slab off of this log, turned it, we're just about to knock the second slab off. Of course, the first one was a really thick one. It actually had a decent 1x6 in it that we threw away. Tried to make this cut where I just got 5 or 6 inches of heartwood on the open face here. Ordinarily, I would probably take a fletch cut off right here, and that would about square this log up, but I'm trying to be really careful not to end up with this cant smaller than the size of the lumber that I need to get out of it for this building project. At the time I'm recording this log being sawn, It's mid to late morning. It's pretty warm out. I don't know, 45, 50 degrees probably, but we had an overnight low in the mid-20s. So you can see that the hydraulics is really working pretty slow this morning. They haven't gotten warmed up yet. It stays pretty cold in this building until pretty late. That would be one design issue with these electric over hydraulics. They're not running all the time because they're just running off of the battery. Of course, it takes less horsepower to do that, but if this hydraulic pump was running continually, the hydraulic fluid would already be warmed up by now and this thing would be operating at full speed. I don't know if you caught that, but I just about left the rear tow board up. When I went to clamp, I had the log stops all the way down, so the little short stop that catches on the cant, because it was up on that tow board, it pushed it over the top of it, was what identified to me that, hey, you've done something wrong. I hear people say, oh, doesn't matter to me which way I have the log loaded, I can cut it either way. Well, I found that I can too, but I prefer to have the small end toward the operator. Then it's much more obvious that the tow board is up because it's right there by me. And it's easier if I need to get measurements to figure out what I can yield out of the log as I turn it and need to get a quick measurement. It's not all the way to the end of the mill to get it. Also, my laser paints a much better line up close to the mill head rather than all the way at the end of the log. Sometimes at the end of the log, it's so faint I have to go down there and hold my hand and let it paint on my hand so that I can see where that's at on the log. Back at the log at hand, we just cut the third slab off and I'm going to cut a couple of fletches off next and get us down to our finished cant size. I haven't been posting a lot of videos lately. About a month ago, I tore something in my right forearm and elbow. I've been kind of nursing it a little bit. Of course, handling this cedar isn't too heavy, and they're pretty short, so I'm going to get these four logs cut up here so I can get the fascia boards finished up on this building. I have been getting some work done. I've did annual preventative maintenance on three pickups and a tractor and riding lawnmower. That first fletch cut we just got a lot of sapwood on it, so it won't really be suitable for this job that we're cutting this for, but the second fletch cut, we can edge it down and make a decent board out of it. It's got plenty of heartwood in it. Now we're going to return the mill head. We'll get the hydraulics going and get this cant stood up and take the last slab off of it. And we'll have it squared down into a pretty good rectangle. Once I get this stood up and the slab off of it, this cant will be about 9 inches tall. So I think it's like 9 by 6 or 7. Well, I could start just cutting down through it, cutting boards out of it. It'd be pretty nice and handy, but it wouldn't yield any of the 9-inch boards that I primarily am trying to get out of this larger of the cedars that I've got. So I'm gonna lay it back down on the mill and cut it all into 4/4 with it laying broadway, and then any of them that have too much sapwood, I'll trim the boards down to 1 by 6s, and the rest of them I'll keep as the 9-inch wide. On the mill today, I'm running a turbo 747 blade that's used, meaning it's cut some previous logs before this one. In fact, this is the one I cut all four of these logs with, in addition to some stuff prior to it. This cedar is a pretty soft wood, all except for the knots, and these happen to have some pretty small knots in them. They have several knots, but they're all pretty small, no large knots in them. So this first cut that I'm making, I've told the set works to divide what's left by 4/4 boards, and when you do that, it works from the bed up, calculating that. And so what I'm left with is just a tiny skim. As I, when we were working on cutting this down, I was just calculating in my head what I needed, and the set works says that this is the variant between what I'd calculated and what it's calculating. So mostly it's just a saw kerf, as you can see going down through here on the, and this also helped true up the cant. So now when we get this cleaned up, we're going to return to the head of the mill and begin sawing these from the top all the way to the bottom, leaving them in a stack. You don't see me doing a lot of cutting this away, but this cedar is pretty stable. So generally speaking, not a lot of flipping required. And if I were going to flip it, all I could do is flip it 180, because I'm really trying to get these 9-inch wide boards out of this little cant we've got going here. The set works that I've got on this sawmill, I bought off the internet somewhere. I don't even recall the name of it at the moment. I can look that up, but I don't have it with me. It, you can have it work from the top down, from the bottom up. It has 4 presets that are fairly easy to change on the fly. You can have it divide the cant by whatever dimensions you'd like. You can set up a sawing scheme where you can cut, say, 4/4, 2 or 3 of them off the top, and then an 8/4 out of the middle to box the hard in, and then back to 4/4 lumber from there to the bottom, all in one cutting scheme. So it works out pretty handy, and it's really accurate. I've been really happy with it so far. The encoder it uses to tell where the sawmill lives in space is a little self-recoiling cable. It's a little box, a little bigger than your fist, has a 1/16-inch wire cable that rolls up in it, and the encoder is in there. So you have to get a wire from that to the SetWorks computer. I have it driving the up-down motor through a winch relay. And then I also have a manual override. And the SetWorks also comes with an up-down button, but I have a manual override that goes directly to that winch motor, just in case the SetWorks ever has any kind of problem. I can keep on cutting until I figure out what's going on with the SetWorks. This video I'm doing a little different than ones I've done in the past. So I'm actually cutting 4 logs in this video. We're down to where we've cut up the first full log here, and I'm fixing to pull all this material off of the sawmill and start another log. This is the only one that I'm going to voice over the entire thing. The other 3 are pretty much unedited completely. Well, if you really enjoy watching sawmilling, there's another hour's worth of it to go. I believe it's in log number 3. If you watch, at one point I forget to put the toe board down on the 3rd cut. Waste about a 4/4 board squaring it back up. But I appreciate everybody tuning in and watching. Don't forget to like the video. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. If you want to, throw me a comment, I'll be sure and try to respond.
Welcome back. I've got another little cedar log on the sawmill. It's about 12 inch on the little end. We're gonna saw this into some four-quarter lumber. We're gonna get started. All right, now then, two little logs, it's 12 inch on the small end. The one I had to cut some barbed wire out of, I didn't quite get what I wanted to get. That's these over here. These are 1 by 8 3/4. And then I got a 2 by 6 underneath for the building. 3 1 by 5s, they got quite a bit of sapwood in them. Let's see, we ended up with 1 2 3 4 of those 8 3/4, and then 9 inch, full 9, which is what I needed. 1 2 3 4 5, and then 8 inch, I got 3, so that's a pretty good little yield for those small logs. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.